With increasing concerns about the state of our planet's environment, many people have decided to go green in a number of ways.
Here at school, all paper is recycled. I have three recycle bins, and my avid students are the ones that take it out and put it in the green box outside. At home, you know, Tulsa has a new recycling can, and I very carefully wash everything out, let it dry, and then put it in my recycling. So I recycle everything they allow. Now, aluminum cans, I give to my sister because she takes them back and gets money for them for the kids.
There's more to being green than just recycling, though. For example, paying attention to how many pages you print on your computer.
You know, I don't think years and years ago, that we even thought about where our trash went. We had no clue. I mean, it wasn't a thought. Now that we know, it's our responsibility because we're filling up land faster than anything. And it's not necessary when you can take these items, recycle them, and make something else out of them that we can use.
You can take all your papers, and you can either recycle them or your yard scraps, your leaves, grass cuttings, and compost them. Put some worms in there as well, red wriggler worms. Buy them at the bait shop, throw them in the pile. Next spring, you will have an excellent pile of compost. Spread it out on the soil. It will provide nutrients. You'll put the worms in the soil, and you'll have a healthy lawn. You don't have to buy chemicals to keep up a good lawn.
Several cleaning supply companies are also taking the initiative to save our environment.
In your home, you can use natural. How do you think they make this orange-scented cleaner? They take a detergent and put orange in it. You can do the same thing. You can take detergents, just like you use in your dishwasher. None of the sulfates, the phosphates, because that hurts the environment. And put the detergent in there. Take some orange peels and put them in there in a blender and blend it up. And you have your orange cleaning detergent. This is not good for the environment. I bought cotton bags, I guess by now it's probably about 7-8 years ago. Five of them, five green ones. I lost one, and only one broke a handle. And I've used those five bags for every time I go to warehouse market or the pet store or anything. That's all I basically use. The only time I have to use bags at the grocery store is if I forget to bring them in. And so just think about the amount of plastic that I save, the environment, just one guy.
The Clorox company has also taken an initiative with the introduction of their Greenworks cleaning supplies.
So, you don't have to buy all these fancy chemicals which destroy the environment. Everything in the back room is on power strips. At the end of the day, when I leave here, I turn off my computer, shut down, but then I'll reach down and turn off the power strip. People at home, everything in my kitchen is on power strips. You know, and I think about it. I have a microwave, and it has a digital clock. I have a coffee pot, and it has a digital clock. And on the stove, there's a digital clock. I mean, how many clocks do I need in my kitchen to tell me what time it is?
Many trees like this one are cut down every year to produce paper for unnecessary uses.
Think about what you do before you do it.
In addition to conserving paper, you can also put the remains of your waste to good use. From carpooling to recycling to even using your own tote bag at the grocery store, you can help save our environment. Reaching new heights from Webster High School, I'm Reginald Fields.